Hey everyone, welcome back. So we've got a new game we're going to be looking at, and this was a suggestion that was sent in to me. And the suggestion was that I take a look at the chess game from the Philosopher's Stone, which is from one of the Harry Potter movies. I myself, I've never actually seen any of them or read any of the books, so I really don't know too much about it, but I do know this chess position. You know, I don't really know too much about them. I was always a fan of these series of unfortunate events. You know, reading all of these books. Those were what I did. So, don't know too much about this. But, I do know chess. So, that's the part I'm going to be able to get right. I'm sure all the details that I don't know, you'll be able to, you know, let me know in the comments and all that stuff. From what I do know, the bishop and the rook cannot be captured in this game, because they represent people, and I believe that the people that they're representing, like they, for that reason, they couldn't be captured. And that actually plays a part in the combination. Okay, so let's go ahead. Yeah, and again, I know about this position because Jeremy Silman is actually my favorite chess writer. I have, like, all of his books, and they were probably the biggest thing, you know, that got me into chess, was reading his books. So let's go ahead and let's take a look at this. Okay, so white to move. They capture the pawn. So after they capture the pawn, the rook moves to c3, because yeah, we can't let the bishop get captured. And also, if you notice, one thing that's really going on here is the white pieces are up 3 points, which is pretty noticeable. Because, you know, what we can do is we can just look at this. We can say, okay, well, let's cancel out all the pieces. You know, the knights cancel, the rooks cancel. So really what you have is two bishops versus a queen. That's what's going on. Because, you know, that's the imbalance we have. But one thing that's really good for the black pieces is this: the white king is very exposed. He doesn't have any protection. So we're going to take advantage of that to, you know, make something happen. So queen takes c3. Now, right here, The move bishop to c5 could actually be played here. Okay, because this would lead to a checkmate in two. You could go bishop to c5. Queen takes. Knight h3 checkmate. However, again, going back to bad arrow. Again, going back to that rule, though, we can't let that bishop get taken. But this would be a checkmate. So it does play a part that bishop can't be captured. So that's why we have to play knight to h3 check. The knight sacrifices itself. It's captured. Now you can play bishop to c5 check. Queen to e3, you know, just a purposeless move, could block this checkmate. And then the bishop would just take it, and then there's checkmate. So this was the position that actually, you know, was created by Jeremy Silman. It was a cool one, I think. Again, I've never actually seen any of that, but I know that the position itself is very cool, and this is a really cool checkmate. And yeah, it goes to show that, you know, you don't need a queen to checkmate, and that it really actually just shows how powerful two bishops are on their own. Like, just look at these things. Just razoring across the board. Yeah, so cool position, good suggestion. All right, you know, thanks for sending it in. You know, send me your suggestions, everyone, if you know any other cool movies or anything else you want to show, you know, go ahead and send me some messages, because I'll go and I'll check them out, you know. All right. You know, and by the way, like and subscribe and comment, all that stuff. It helps other people find my channel, and, you know, so everyone can learn about chess. All right.